even though I should still have a couple more minutes between the buildings and the hills off in that direction, I basically talked my way out of it. But what you were hearing, you know, a couple of the stations were around Chicago. The WB2, he said where he was, Armonk, New York, near New York City. And the satellite was passing over basically the Mississippi River, you know, the footprint spreading coast to coast. Unfortunately, not far enough to go across the Atlantic, but not as many do the single sideband satellites, because this is about the minimal setup that you need unless you get a satellite radio like an ICOM 910 or an FT847. I'm using just two FT817s here. I could replace this with an all-mode receiver. I don't have to have a second transceiver, but I would need at least one as my transmitter. Question? I was transmitting up around 432.140-150 in that range. I was adjusting because of the Doppler effect as the satellite was moving. I started out at 145.960 on the satellite downlink. I ended up moving down to, since nobody was coming up to work me, I moved down to 145.954. There were other stations there and they, you know, let me, you know, they were still calling me, so they, you know, essentially let me have it.
Were the satellites traveling north-south?
In that case, it was traveling from south to north. It was starting out about due east and was wrapping around toward the north as it was going behind the hills. And I'm running just 5 watts off this radio.
Oh, wow.
It's unmodified.
That's awesome.
And for an almost 40-year-old satellite, its 70-centimeter receiver was built with very good sensitivity. On the other hand, its other mode, where it's 2 meters up and 10 meters down, the 2-meter receiver is a little deaf, but I have worked it with this setup and a portable dipole for the 10-meter downlink antenna instead of using the log periodic.
That works pretty well.
It works okay. There's noticeable fades, so you know I haven't found a good, you know, easily repeatable solution to dealing with the 10-meter fades. Plus, if the band is open, it's going to play havoc with the satellite signal. You know, they may hear the downlink on the other side of the Pacific before I hear it clearly. Propagation's good.
Is there any kind of like a tripod setup or that you were saying to do it?
I could. I've seen some who put an antenna like this or the AO-7 on a tripod and they make it so they can at least twist the antenna 90 degrees to vary the, you know, to vary the orientation of the elements. You know, without that, you know, just twist the wrist and away you go.
So it looks like you're within 10 degrees and you're doing okay.
Yeah, the satellite, you know, with the smaller antenna, the beam width's a bit wider. I can't be pointing north at the end. The satellite's east, but I can be close. If, you know, a few degrees off isn't going to be huge compared to a satellite, say, at 30,000 miles away. You better be, you know, dead on accurate or your signal's not making it. But something like this is adequate. I've taken, you know, the antenna goes in a check bag for air travel. Everything else goes in that laptop bag. And I don't take the battery with me. I'll either use the internal packs in these two radios or tap into, say, a cigarette lighter of a car if I want external power. The battery life, even with the aftermarket battery packs in these radios, is still, you know, the transmit radio, I might get, you know, 4 or 5 passes before the voltage starts crying at me. The receiver could probably go all weekend and into next week without a recharge. Or you flip-flop back and forth and kill them both. So before I need to recharge them during the weekend.
Where's your booth at?
It's right in the middle of the room, right where the tables for the tomorrow night's barbecue start. There's a big signpost that has, right next to. And I'll come out tomorrow during the day as well, and either with this or with the dual band mobile radio or handheld to demonstrate the other satellites that work in FM as well as, like Oscar 7 with single sideband. This was. Yeah, Oscar 7 for this configuration, it's retransmitting a 50 kilohertz band, pass band. So there were several others, you know, a couple guys doing CW further down on the band. It's just like on HF, the low end of the pass band is typically for CW, higher up for phone. And most people don't do CW on the satellites, although I can hold with the right hand and tap with my left, and I'm not left-handed. I've worked straight key night that way. I'll usually disable the keyer and use one of the levers and just, you know, be like a vertical straight key for that.
That looks like a homeroom. You could build that at home.
You could build it. This is made by Elk Antennas. HRO, AES, and those places sell it. I don't know if anybody in here has them this weekend, but there are log periodic designs online, like there are the dual band Yagi designs that, you know, many are familiar with. So yeah, if you already have the radios, the antennas, if you're willing to build them, antennas are cheap. The radios, aftermarket, used, you can find the, you know, FT-817s have been made for over a decade, so they're out there on the used market. And even if the final transistors are dead, it still works as a good all-mode receiver for this sort of thing.
Yeah.
Or call Yaesu in LA and get the new transistor module and put it in and take care of the failures of the original model.
So most of the dual, I'm kind of new at this game.
Mm-hmm. There's
a lot of
bands,
they don't have a sideband, right?
Right. Most of them, like, you have a handheld radio in your pocket. Most of them will only transmit and receive an FM. There are some that will transmit an FM but have an all-mode receiver, so they can actually listen to that. And I have a Kenwood THF6 that I'll sometimes put here as my receiver.